The research that we do in my own laboratory is very basic, because the basic chemical understanding of what goes wrong when a protein doesn't fold correctly is not well understood. So there's an increasing number of diseases that we now know have as their origin a mistake in protein folding. Alzheimer's, Huntington's, Parkinson's, several cancers also have a protein misfolding mistake. And so we then developed some expertise in approaches to understanding how proteins fold and what happens when they don't fold correctly. So what we're trying to understand is the protein folding process itself. And what we're most excited about is looking at that in a more cellular environment, which really hasn't been done up until the last couple of years. We need to understand how proteins fold correctly in order to understand what happens when they don't get it right. So understanding the folding, understanding how the chaperones work, and this whole quality control is what we're trying to do in our lab at a very basic level. And so we've had over the last few years, because we're one of the labs that does this, a lot of inquiries and a lot of contact from pharmaceutical industry, both big pharma and startup companies, that realize that this is a huge area of human need. It's an unmet medical need to try to come up with any sort of therapeutic approach to protein misfolding. Quite recently, we were delighted because two or three projects that are going on in the lab are coming together to really have a eureka moment, a moment where we understand better something about a fundamental folding process. We've just discovered that in the lab for this protein we've been looking at for a number of years, that it's breathing. And its breathing is necessary for it to fold and function. But it also told us that there is probably an inherent risk in most of our proteins. And we know that in many cases, the mechanism is similar from one of these diseases to another. So if we can understand them at a basic level, then we basically will open the door to therapeutic intervention for a wide array of target diseases. We took some risks in the lab and decided we were going to do some very difficult projects. We were fortunate to get what's called a Pioneer Award, and this is an award that basically gives you 5 years of funding at a quite high level to do something that is deemed to be extremely significant if it works, but extremely high risk. And so we took on folding in the cell because we knew that we needed to understand this protein folding mystery inside the complex environment of the cell in order to make the next breakthroughs. And then we also continued on this trend and formed a partnership on UMass with Dan Hebert's lab and Ann Gershenson's lab, and we're able to get what's called a Eureka Award from the NIH, which is also to support the inherently high-risk but incredibly important work. The old silo approach to solving problems is not going to crack the problems of the future. What we need are partnerships, we need different ways of looking at the problem, we need hard sciences, math and physics, computational work, as well as the life sciences, where we understand the physiology and the medical context of a problem. And that has to happen together. So we try to encourage that on campus, and we train our students that this is the way they need to work. So the partnership between a campus like UMass and industry is, first of all, absolutely essential.